Okay, we survived. We did a late question and answer session on Saturday. If you haven't seen that, that video is probably up. We got up early this morning with the idea of listing Saturday today instead of going picking on
the crazy picker life. With Wheeler, Dealer, and Banana Peeler.
It's Saturday. It'd be a great day to pick, but instead we're in the office. Welcome, fellow pickers and would-be adventurers. Dealer here with the Crazy Picker Life Saturday in the office edition. Well, crappy weather. Not a good day to get out of town. We had to make the decision to scrub going out of town. We're going to take advantage of that today and do some listing. I've got 6 or 8 orders to pack up and get down to USPS. I'm going to try to keep myself away from picking locations. I got to get back and get a bunch of stuff listed today. I'll show those items. Without further ado, I better get my orders packed and get my butt in gear. I don't have any in there. I don't think there's going to be more than a tote. Probably a full tote. Maybe a few extra boxes. Let me get that out of the way and we'll see where we're at. A couple of interesting items I'm packing today. I'll just give you a quick glimpse. This is a Capers Farmer National Protective Service $50 reward sign in poor condition. I think I paid 10 bucks. And it took a little while to sell. Still got some character. It's a small sign. Sold for $31.40 plus shipping going to California. Ship it. All right, so the second thing I want to show here, and probably the only other one right now, Hasselblad accessories are starting to sell. And we did a whole bunch of listing. Wheeler did a whole bunch of listing of some Hasselblad accessories. This is a lens flange mount adapter. Hasselblad. We paid a couple bucks probably for each of these pieces. This one's a good one. If you see this kind of thing for the right price, you want to pick up Hasselblad accessories. Sold for $56.22 going to Rhode Island. Let's ship that. All right, so orders packed, right? Orders packed for now. Tote full, extra one, no big deal. Slow day. I think everybody was preoccupied with the Trump inauguration and all the antics going on around it. Whoa, what's this setup?
Super time-lapse, man.
Super time-lapse over here?
Mm-hmm. No, it's for listing over here.
Oh, you're over there. Mm-hmm. I see. So I probably shouldn't enter the time-lapse zone. See what that's all about. You got like some stuff scrolling on through on your phone. Install. Is that your game?
Oh, no. Some sort of ad.
Wow.
Advertisement sort of time-lapse.
So you're getting a good start.
Good start.
A run-up.
Items ready.
How many?
How long I started, 9 items.
Wow, that's more than I packed.
Yeah.
Well, you had yourself like pre-pictured and ready to go, right?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm going to go take my stuff into USPS. You need anything?
Nope, I need a tote when you get back.
Well, I'll be back pretty quick. I'm not going to dawdle out there. I forced myself to wear these shoes, which I feel, these aren't really shoes. I feel subconscious about going in public with, so if I do zip in places, I'm like out of there quick.
Yeah.
I don't get all cozy. So, your take on the 1977 Smokey and the Bandit.
Great. New Ricky Bobby, the best thing ever.
The new old Ricky Bobby, best thing ever?
Yeah, pretty good.
So, did we get an accurate view, you think, of the South?
Yeah. Now we're going to go out picking and the flea market is just going to be full of crazy people.
That's your impression, huh?
I don't know. It'll be fun.
Yeah, we meaning you, we haven't spent much time in the South. I think if we spend some time in
South Carolina, Georgia, Mississippi, Alabama, Louisiana.
Yeah.
That could be fun at the flea markets there.
Mm-hmm.
We've got a whole interesting crew that we work with out here at the flea markets out here, but boy, I bet you there's a whole bunch of fun waiting for us.
It's kind of funny, there's like East Coast, West Coast, and there's Central where we're kind of at, and man, this is going to be all different things in between.
Yeah. It's going to be an eye-opener.
Yeah, fun.
Hope we, what's the sheriff's name there? Jackie Gleason played him, but...
Yeah, Bronson T. Justice, was that his name?
Bronson?
I don't know, something like that, started with a B.
Yeah, Buford.
Buford, that's it. Yeah, he was close.
Buford T. Justice. Now, he was from Texas.
Mm-hmm.
And then the bandit was...
Georgia.
Burt Reynolds was from Georgia. The closer he got to Georgia, boy, he had a lot of fans, didn't he?
Yeah, it was pretty good.
Everybody had their ears on the CB.
Yeah, you get a CB in the van, man.
Yeah.
Start driving it crazy down the highway, have all our fans helping us.
Breaker 1-9 for a flea market report.
Wheeler or the dealer.
Yeah, okay. All right, gotta go.
Yeah.
So I forgot I had these in there. These are eBay boxes that they sent me for free because I have a store, eBay store. These are 12 by 12 by 12. Got three boxes of these, just took one in. Gotta get them out of here before I put my orders in here. Oh yeah, well, watched Smokey and the Bandit with the boys last night, 1977. It's like 40 years ago. I was 9 years old when that came out, and I think, I can't remember if Burt Reynolds' movie Hooper, where he was a stuntman, Hooper, came out before or after that. I think it came out after that, and it must have been a PG movie or PJ. I don't know if they had PG-13 when I was 10 or 12. I don't remember. But for my birthday, I went with some kids and watched Hooper. And I think that came out after, just after Smokey and the Bandit, somewhere there. And Burt Reynolds was the man ticket. He was a star at that time, boy. He really started up after that. Simpler times in the 70s. Boy, you can just, I mean, movies obviously portray a Hollywoodized version of the truth, no matter what. You go all the way back to the beginning of movies, but you can just really feel a completely different pre-internet vibe. Oh, kids got a kick out of it, and obviously some good acting from Jackie Gleason of the Honeymooners fame towards the end of his life and career as Sheriff Buford T. Justice. And the dude in the semi-truck was sort of likable, some sort of country western star that did a movie, Jerry Reed, I think, or something like that. It's interesting, he sang most of the songs in there, you know, Westbound and Down and all that, trucking bandit songs. Had sort of a catchy theme song and things like that. I don't remember how good that movie did, but it did pretty well. And then, you know, Smokey and the Bandit 2 and Smokey and the Bandit 3 obviously had varied success. Hooper, what else came out in there? Cannonball Run. Crazy movies. All right, gotta do it. You know, one of the things we talk about sometimes on this channel is the frustration between sellers trying to make a living and people buying products and cheating and sending stuff back and breaking stuff and asking for discounts after they get it, and just the general attitude that a lot of people in this country have. And you know, it started a long time ago. But when we watch these movies like Smokey and the Bandit, which obviously are fun movies, you gotta understand this mindset of something for nothing It has been sown in the seeds of our media and our movies for a long time. If you don't believe me, here's a couple of examples. Okay, it's Smokey and the Bandit. You're making fun of the police, first of all, which I respect the police. And obviously, as any situation, there can be jokes and fun made about any group, right? But obviously, these police were comical. They're all wrecking their cars and they're all behaving like madmen for the most part, including, you know, Buford T. Justice. He's just a piece of work, right? And so, ha ha ha, funny. But the underlying message is the bandit, who basically is a thief in a sense, a something for nothing opportunist adventurer of the worst kind, he outwits the, you know, the police. And so he goes to pick up these cases of Coors beer, and he goes there and the place is closed. Well, he's on a schedule, so he justifies breaking in the place. Ha ha ha, they make that comical, loads it up. They don't pay for it because nobody's still around. They're gonna leave a note that you know, big and small Enos, you know, charge them. Except the truck driver guy starts writing the note and he runs out of time, so he's like, forget it, and he throws it. So basically they steal the Coors, right? Ha ha ha, cheer for the bandit. So I always have mixed feelings about movies like that, because you're supposed to cheer for the bad guy. The bad guy is supposed to represent the person in all of us that wants to come out the bad side, right? When in reality, we should want to be good. We should want to work hard. We should want to make a difference. And so in a sense, it undermines all that should be good in this country. That's the mixed messages that movies have sent out forever and ever and ever, and continue to send out even more so today, starting with the kids' cartoons and all the bull crap. All right, that's me on a soapbox for today. But hey, it's true. You are what you watch. All right, I'm stopping for 5 minutes at the flea market. I promise. 11:13, 5 minutes max. Okay, 11:21, I didn't do too bad. I don't remember what my first time was, so in and out, nothing new, nothing that great. Can always spend money in there if I want. Big load of stuff coming in Sunday, I guess she said. And so I'll have to check back maybe Wednesday. Oh, I gotta fill the steering pump on this thing. You can hear it. The van number two on its way out. Squeeze out the toothpaste the end of the tube. So that place is called the flea market, not to be confused with a swap meet or flea market or the Denver Mile High flea market that we like to go to. This is my local little antique slash junk stop and shop buy place. Find some good things in there. Find some bad things in there. Mostly good. I get an education in there because there's always something to look at or look up or whatever, you know. So how did we do on the questions and answers yesterday? Did we answer everything? Hopefully. It's hard when you get, I don't know, in a week I must get 100 or 200 comments, maybe more. It's hard to do a show as long-winded as I and Wheeler are, mostly me. It's hard to do a show reading back through the comments. We just don't get much more than a week back. That took 2 hours, so I'm still contemplating how often we should do those question and answer shows. Probably twice a month, and just kind of mention when we're going to be doing them. I think that's going to be it. Okay, I'm at 11:30 a.m. Not too bad since we got home about 1:30. Orders packed. Video's not quite up yet from yesterday. It takes a long time to render that thing. And I've got to add a few special notations to it since it was a sponsored video. Got to make sure that's all snug. And let's see what else. sale of the day. I think we've got a good one. I got to do that sometime today. Little segment, sale of the day. Been getting decent feedback on that. Not a lot of people, I shouldn't say that. A lot of people like the creepy bunny. However, it got a lot of thumbs down, more than any other sale of the day. So obviously that incited some negativity. Oh my goodness, I gotta get a kick out of it. All right, I've gotta do some listing. I wanna get squared away, do some listing. And then I'm gonna go home and have a Saturday power shake. Get it going, get it going. Turn off the camera.
Okay, gonna start, you know, Blatsman has been watching over my telescope lenses and stuff over there. I'm gonna start taking all this telescope stuff and listing bits and pieces of it. Let's start with this. This is Celestron Reducer Corrector Model 94175. I'm gonna list that for $89.99. plus shipping, listed. Okay, so here's some sort of an eyepiece. It's a Vixen brand, LV 10 millimeter, 50 degree, fully multi-coated, long eye relief, 20 millimeter. Whatever all that means, I'm gonna list that at $60 plus shipping. List that, number two. Okay, here's another telescope lens, an LV 6 millimeter Vixen, listed that at $60 plus shipping. That's number three. All right, listing four, I got some test strips in today in the mail. Here's 18 of these Aviva, EcuCheck Aviva Plus 50 size. I'm gonna list these to my set buyer at $25 a box times 18, that's $450 listed, and they'll probably be sold quick. Number five is a Meade, M-E-A-D-E, eyepiece for a telescope. List that for $30 plus shipping. That might be a little high for this, but only one available and a bunch sold for less. There we go. This is a Celestron Star Diagonal. $30 plus shipping. Number six listed. Okay, number seven is this Celestron 25 millimeter Kellner MC multi-coated model 93007. Listed that up. $40 plus shipping. Okay, so listing, I think 82468 is this Meade 1A filter. Some of this stuff is kind of tough to price. One of these sold used for $25, one bid plus shipping. And then there's one currently for sale, $99.95 or best offer plus shipping. And so I think the $99.95 is a bit high. Although there's two watchers, I put this at $50 plus shipping, and I think that's where it needs to be listed. Number nine is a solar flare filter glass C8 type filter, listed it for $80 plus shipping. It's in great shape. Okay, Celestron C8 original. Telescope tube, it's got some extras on it, finder, whatever this sort of mechanicalized, computerized, electrified, I don't have a cord for it, but the bottom piece has some tracking or something built into it. Manual, case, I'm going to put some of the extras that don't sell well together in there, $399.99, $400 plus shipping. Is what I'll list that for. And then the tripod, there are people selling these two together. I think that limits the sale in this case. I really don't want to deal with this because shipping it is such a pain. I can't really figure out if this top piece is something that I would sell separately, so I am going to list this separately. My guess, $100 plus shipping, and we'll wait and see, and we'll just reduce it out. I'm going to have to break it down and measure it. It's a pain. Shipping's expensive, super heavy. This thing's heavy, but at least it's square and it's more compact than that. Selling these together, I wouldn't get much more for the tripod. That's why I'm going to separate it. If somebody asks me, is there a tripod, I'll say I've got it listed separately. If it sells, I don't have it. So that is what we will do. That is listing 9 and 10 or 10 and 11. I don't know. All right, so my last two items that I listed are these two hot point signs that you've seen. I put them over here to try to keep them close at hand and sort of out of the way and keep people safe that are walking through this hallway. I thought about putting them behind the chairs here. I got some other junk back there, unfortunately, but when people recline, they're going to get caught up in them and rip the sofa, so that's not a good idea. So let's get a total and put that up. I'm at about 8 o'clock at night, and I want to get a jump on my orders for Monday. I've got a stack of them I got to work on. 13 items listed, a total of $2,270. That's a pretty good day. That's the kind of mix between number of items and dollars I'd like to do. When I say $2,270, I'm so fuzzy. My computer, otherwise known as my camera, didn't like that. There I am. Yay.
Let's see. Oh.
Well, we certainly are getting a lot of interesting comments on the question and answer video. I sort of thought that that would bring out quite a mix of comments and support, and also people leaving the channel. We couldn't provide the kind of content that they wanted. So let's see what Wheeler's having a big day here. He's almost filled up his listing table. So when I work hard, Wheeler works hard. When I don't work hard, because I rarely do, Wheeler still works hard.
Yeah.
So what kind of dollars are you going to have here? We're going to have a pretty good dollar listing day.
Yeah, should be pretty good.
I put up a couple grand, so you'll probably have a couple grand.
Yep.
You need me to bring you more stuff?
Shortly.
You'll let me know?
Yep, I'll let you know.
You haven't given up yet? We got three hours till we're...
I haven't given up yet. I have a little bit more to go.
3 hours till we're done. Done.
Yep, oh, that's right. I was going to put my other video live, so I got to do that.
Okay, well, I won't bother you. Good video yesterday. I think we shook things up.
Yeah.
We got a mix of quite a few thumbs up and quite a few thumbs down.
Fun.
And lots of people enjoying the content and a few leaving the channel.
Yeah.
In disgust. They're going to go watch some other channels. Okay. Well, like I said, I think I've got, 7, 8, 9 orders, including... I've got to pack that up for UPS, that Zenith sign. Sold those test strips for $450. I got paid on that. Bunch of other stuff. I'm not going to show all that. We had a real long video yesterday. I know some people said it's too long, and of course other people will say it's not too long. And oh, it's so funny. It really is funny. Interesting. Very, very interesting. Thanks for watching. I read all your comments. I appreciate the good ones. Oh my goodness. If you like the video, give us a thumbs up. If you don't like the video, I don't know. I guess you're probably not watching anymore, right? There shouldn't be any more thumbs down, because all the people who put thumbs down aren't watching anymore. They told me they left the channel. We'll have a vlog of some kind tomorrow. It is Packers, Atlanta Falcons game. Go Packers. We'll see how that goes. I have to come up with a topic of sorts to dig deep. Something picking, something about picking, buying, selling, eBay, something. Pick well. Whoop. What mail, Siri? It's 8 o'clock. Pick well this often. Thanks for watching. Dealer out.
Hey, Wheeler.
Dealer production.